You know my man Prodigy is in the house. What's up, Prodigy?
Ain't nothing, man. You know, just out here showing love to the people. Do our little show, man. Represent for Infamous Records, you know what I'm saying? Put it down, H&IC.
Check this shit, man. Check this shit, man. Wait, it's over. Y'all ready? Come on.
In the new millennium, during the Y2K scare, Prodigy released his debut album, H&IC, Head Nigga in Charge.
I'm the head nigga in charge.
No better than this. It's the hottest shit on the street. It move units like Shania Twain on a mall beat. The solar system stands still. The gods listen when I speak. The world pay attention. It's capital P.
Since my album was called Head Nigga in Charge, I was sitting on a throne in the ads. The idea came from the end of the movie Conan the Barbarian, where Conan sat on the throne like he was king of the world. Keep It Thorough took off.
I remember being like 11, 12, seeing the Keep It Thorough video.
Used to catch those on the block with crills. Now it's paid shows, promoters post up bills. Sign deals only if the math is real. If you can't match numbers, then you can't have the head in charge. Live rhymes artists.
Keep It Thorough
thing
was killing them in the streets right now, hard.
Yeah, man, we know how we put it down. We try to put that straight ghetto shit, straight streets to the Ivory Curse, right?
After Mobb Deep's Quiet Storm, Prodigy showed off his lyrical skills and solo album was anticipated. When I copped the album, I had it on repeat from front to back. But my favorite track on there was 3, and that was my introduction to Core Mega.
My life, I got my uptown Nikes ducked out and icy. Mad D jumping out the cocaine YG. Crew was struggling, so I resume hustling. Rap game, a crack game, my crew is still bubbling. Yo, 3 in the morning and the D's on the corner still. Scenes we was born to kill, your P, meet me on the hill.
He also had the video YBE, Young Black Entrepreneurs, featuring BG, who was on fire at the time.
Billions. You couldn't understand my pain if you lived it. Give me the riches and all of my thuns and be driving. It's beautiful to see the click live comfortable.
To the Young Black Entrepreneurs, get rich, get money, get paper, get paid. Keep yourself laced, get your ones, get your duns out the slums.
To the Young Black Entrepreneurs,
get dollars, get cash, straight up, don't give. Get your bucks and get big. Stash your first millions and live off the interest.
To the Young Black Entrepreneurs.
We toured the entire East Coast and Midwest. And while we were in Chicago for a performance at our boy Ron Artest's birthday party, an interview I did in The Source came out. I picked up a copy in the Chicago airport when we landed. The Source put me on the cover, my first magazine cover as a solo artist. In the interview, the writer, Shaheen Reed, asked about my problem with Jay-Z, referencing an online interview in which they asked if I liked Jay-Z. No, he's a bitch boy. He talking and don't live it, I said. I elaborated for The Source. Jay-Z has a quote in his song, Money Cash Hoes, where he claims,
dealings, huh? It's like New York's been soft ever since Snoop came through and crushed the buildings. I'm trying to restore the feelings. Fuck the law.
But Jay was nowhere to be found when that drama popped off between Mobb Deep, Dog Pound, Tupac, and Biggie. That was our little personal beef, not a coastal war. Jay-Z ain't had shit to say when it was on, and he was getting dissed. Him and Nas. Mobb Deep and Biggie were the only ones from New York active in that situation. So Jay-Z is a bitch-ass nigga for making that quote in his lyrics. Yeah, it was on there.
As we all remember it, Summer Jam and on Takeover. Do you still listen to the Infamous? Like, I feel like Mobb Deep, since you buried them, has sometimes, because you're so influential, have gotten overlooked when I truly think they're, you know, one of the great rap groups.
I think they're fantastic.
And you still, do you ever still listen?
Yeah. I think they're great. I think Prodigy at one time was, you know, one of the best rappers in the game. I don't know about ever, but I mean, in the game, at one point he was definitely...
He was up there.
He was close to being the best rapper. For a period of time, he was close to being the best rapper in the game.
Yeah. In the mid to late 90s.
Yeah.
I mean, his appearances were crazy. The I Shot You appearances and all that different shit was retarded.
The name of the what Prodigy mean is like a child genius, you know what I mean? Like a gifted child. They call him a prodigy, you know what I mean? So that's not why I picked the name, but I just thought the name was there. I like how it sounded, you know what I mean? Prodigy.
I want to really focus on was that the one album that he dropped, actually his first solo project in the early 2000s, right before the hip hop scene and the music business just really took a turn for the left, where the digital era started coming in, the Atlanta hip hop started really taking off, and you know, and the rap just started really changing for what it is, what we know for today. But Prodigy, he dropped the H&IC, which I believe is to be the last real hip hop album to ever come out at the turn of the millennium, and that's probably a real strong statement. But when you look at it, and from the point of view that he was coming from, giving you that straight grimy street hip hop right off the heels of Murder Music, and when you combine that with the climate that was currently going on in hip hop, he was trying to really hit you hard. Like, no, the street grimy rap was not going away. On Prodigy's first debut album, he went and produced 8 of his own songs. That is unheard of at this time from someone who's not known of being a producer, say like Havoc. So on these 8 songs, say four of them were like skits and intros, so we'll count the intro and outro. So, you know, this was an album by the 90s hip hop definition. So when it dropped in the 2000, you gotta understand this was the last real hip hop album. Hip hop albums don't give you outros, intros, 3-4 skits anymore, 15 quality songs, 3 verses, 2 hooks. They don't do that anymore. Let's really think about it. Real hip hop heads who grew up on this stuff, who relate to me right now, they could tell you they don't do that anymore. This is a dying art form, dying craft in itself, you know? Like, they just 2 verses, 2 hooks, song's done, maybe a feature, but that's a record now, you know? We're talking songs at like 3 minutes, 4 minutes, you know, good records right here. So.
With the Dilly P, Iraq, and by QB. And you know we smashed the industry negatively. So fuck a good boy, I always been a foul hood boy. You know, as a youth I had wingworms and all that shit.
Yo, twin,
they had
us
locked out on the ground, holding us down. With gas too, back our heads was going down. It wasn't us that held up that bitch you got. With the proof, man, let me speak to my attorney. I know the routine, don't try to throw me. I've been getting knocked since 12 and my mom tried to scold me. But all I told me,
oh no, we can't complain. Just another day living in New York, dealing with the jakes and the snakes. Feeling good today. We hear the but we here to stay.
Yo, littles, man. Tell them niggas how we got down in the hood, man. You know how we doing in QB, man. Let them niggas know how we got up, world.
Yo, my first whip in the ghetto, I was popping off. 14 and had older broads dropping drawers. I'm supposed to be in school, but I'm chasing ones, surrounded by these snakes in these faceless slums.
Like,
yo,
this.
Have you ever had a bitch that'll pop guns for you?
Type of nigga, you do anything he asks to.
Snake bitch, turn around and backstab you.
Crab nigga found out he fucking round too.
We ain't going platinum, we ain't going gold. We going diamond, 10 million sold. We break records and move units, that's how we do it. Making millions and billions from movies and music. World.
Word.
And Chris was also the one that told you about the Quiet Storm controversy, correct?
Yeah, so Quiet Storm was a record that I made for H&IC, for the H&IC
album. Oh, wow, I didn't know that.
And actually, Quiet Storm was, when I first made the record, I gave it to Clue. You know what I'm saying? And put on the mixtapes and whatnot. So Clue just went crazy with it.
You just had like a verse on there, right? Just one verse.
Nah, I think it was like 2 verses.
Okay.
But it was just like super rough.
Yeah, yeah.
And I just put it out there, you know what I mean? And Clue like pressed up vinyl and was playing it in the club. I was in the tunnel one night and it came on. I was bugging and everybody was like rocking to it.
They knew it already. Yeah.
I was like, yo, this is crazy, yo. I just made the song like a couple weeks ago. Like, what the hell? So that was the first time I ever seen that. So then from there, the record just like, after about a year, you know what I'm saying? A year or two. All right, because I put it out early. So about a year or two, that's when we put Little Kim on it and did a remix to it. After it was already rocking for 2 years, like on the street.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And the reason why we did that is because the song got so hot and Mobb Deep needed a single for the next album. And Chris was like, yo, what's up with this record you got here, man?
Yeah.
I'm like, this for my solo album. He was like, yo, listen, give that to Mobb Deep. Mobb Deep need a single, and that's rocking right now. And I was like, come on, man, that's my song.
$1 billion ambition.